Hey, welcome to the Small Business Made Simple podcast, brought to you by socialmediaandmarketing.com.au. Being in business is never easy, but it can be simple, or at least simpler. Join me, your host Jen Donovan, every week where we focus on marketing, social media, and working towards simplifying your business. You with me? Let's do this. Gonna dream it big, 'cause someone out there listening. Everyone's got a voice to give, and it's time. Well, hello there and welcome. Welcome to episode 14 of the Small Business Made Simple podcast. Thank you so much for joining me again this week. Now, my business philosophy, as you might tell from the name of my podcast, is that business is actually simple, but it's definitely not easy, and there's a massive distinction between the two. And I'm sure I don't need to tell any of you about that. That's for sure. I guess a lot of business is about being consistent and making a commitment. And for those of you who follow me on social media or listen to perhaps episode one of the Small Business Made Simple podcast, you'll know at the end of 2018, coming into 2019, that I made a commitment to do 52 of these, one a week for 52 weeks. One of these being the podcast you're listening to so far, at the moment. So far, so good. But I'm going to put it up a little notch. You see, I've created this little Facebook group called Like-Minded Business Owners. And I would absolutely love you to join. If you go over to Facebook and search Like-Minded Business Owners and perhaps join in and join in the fun. We all belong to so many Facebook groups. I really get that. And I've been pondering to myself, what can I do that's a little bit different? Because that's how this podcast come along. You know, what could I do that's a little bit different? So again, I'm making the commitment in the Facebook group, in Like-Minded Business Owners, to go live once a week to help you, my listener, and anybody else out there in the small business world, to help them with their biggest challenges and those really burning, perhaps, marketing and social media questions that you might have. I get a lot of text messages during the week. Can you just quickly have a look at this for me? Or can you tell me what that means? So I thought maybe if I went live inside my group once a week, that might help all of those people out there with burning questions. So I thought I'd go live every Thursday. So if you want to connect and get a little bit social on social, head over to join my group, Like-Minded Business Owners. I would love you to connect there and say hi. Maybe when you get in there, just introduce yourself and I'll pop in and say hi. So I'd love you to join in my group. But let's get on to today's episode. Today, I've got a really special guest for you. Her name is Jules Brooke. She's coming along to talk to us on how we can get and win free PR for our business. So PR stands for press release. So basically, Jules is coming on. She's going to tell us how we can all get ourselves in more magazines and more newspapers and online blogs or even on TV. And trust me, it's really not as hard as it sounds. So stick with me. I promise you that, Jules has got some fantastic tips and tricks, and I guarantee it's not near as hard as what you think it is. So whether you're in a big business, small business, micro, medium, or whatever, free PR is an absolutely fabulous way to not only help you build your audience, you know, your customer and your client base, but also to set yourself up as the expert in the industry that you work in, whatever that industry is. But first, before we get to Jules, of course, we need to do our discovery of the week. And this week's discovery has come to me just in time this week. As I mentioned just before, I've got a guest, Jules, coming on today to chat to us. So what I normally do when I have a guest coming on is I do show notes and I do transcripts of mine and obviously the guest's conversation. Just so that if people want to go to my show notes, they can actually just download them and read it rather than listen to it. And normally I'd use Rev, so that's R-E-V. Rev, so www.rev.com, and that's how I would normally transcribe all my videos that I do, whether they're for social media or for this podcast. And they're really good, but I came across this other one. So Rev costs about $1 a minute to do. And it's a really good service and I really love it. But I came across this other one called otter.com otter.ai. So otter, O-T-T-E-R, .ai. And it's basically a free transcription service that you can just go onto them, upload your audio file, and it will transcribe it for you. It was really super easy, and that's all I did. It took about 2 or 3 minutes, but I think that had more to do with the fact that my internet connection wasn't so grand than what it did about the platform itself. Was it as good as Rev? So Rev is obviously what I pay for. Otter.ia is free. Was it as good as Rev? No. Look, it wasn't. I really did find that I had to go through and correct some words that were wrong and some phrases, and that did take me a little bit more time. But would I use it again? Absolutely. Probably not for the podcast, but definitely for shorter videos, like ones that you put on social media, because having captions on our videos on social media is becoming more and more important because people are listening without the sound on. And so to get our message across, we need the words running across the page. So if you are in need of a transcription service for any of your videos, you know, I guess this week's discovery is kind of two. If you haven't heard of Rev.com, then there's one discovery. But if you have and you were looking for a free platform to do it on, go to otter.ai. Of course, all the links are in my show notes. So it's well worth a look. And hopefully it can help you get over that little hurdle of having some transcriptions done of your videos in your business. Let's get on to the episode. I am really excited, but just before I bring Jules on, I just want to tell you a little bit about her. I've actually known Jules for about 3 or 4 years now, and we met in a business setting. And hand on heart, she is probably one of the most passionate people I have ever met when it comes to their business. I really love Jules, and I actually think that we get along so well because she's a little bit like me. She's like, go hard or go home. You know, be 100% into something or just don't even bother to try. And so I really love that of her, and you will hear her passion for her Handle Your Own PR business as we continue on the conversation. Jules founded Handle Your Own PR back in about 2008 after the GFC made funds really tight and there was a lot of strapped cash small businesses out there. She'd run her own small business and she'd specialized in small business PR for lots of years prior to that. Jules has actually seen the power of PR transform and grow businesses firsthand. She also knows that many businesses have incredible stories to tell. That's you, my listener. And that media are desperate for new content all the time, and that PR is the process that can be taught. So with this knowledge, Jules has set out to empower all of our small business owners on how to manage our own PR and how to get some PR for our business. So I know you're going to love this episode with Jules, so let's get right into it. So thanks, Jules. Thanks so much for joining us on the podcast today. For those out there who don't know you, can you tell us a little bit about Jules Brooks and what Handle Your Own PR is all about?
I sure can. Okay, so I basically fell into PR myself in about 2003 when I had a little baby, and I got a job from someone which was to do with PR, and I didn't have a clue how to do it, but I really needed the work. So I kind of taught myself how to do it. And then on the back of that, I set up an agency and we specialized in small businesses and startups. And then, so I did that from about 2003 whilst running the agency until about 2014. And then I thought, you know what? I just want to focus on Handle Your Own PR. So I gave my agency away to my business partner who had helped me found Handle Your Own PR, and she gave me this one. And at the time she said, I think you've made the wrong decision. It was great. And I was like, no, I haven't, because I love teaching people how to do PR. So on the back of that, in 2017, we launched a PR platform, which is really unique. There isn't anything really like it in the world, particularly targeting small business owners.
Wow. So
a platform where it's at handleyourownpr.com.au. And what you do is you can go on, you choose the media that you want to contact. So I've got categories and subcategories. So you choose who your target market is. And then you choose whether you want TV, radio, print, or whatever. And then there's a template on there so that you can write your media release. And then you actually get to see the journalists' names their phone numbers, their email addresses, and you choose who you want to send it to. And you can send it from the platform. It goes from your own email address, so all the answers go back from the journalist to you. But it's a really easy way that you can send out and then do your follow-up. So it's all in one platform, and it's less than $400 a year. So that has always been my focus, to make things affordable for small business owners. And then I started training people, and I've got two or three different coaching programs now. Almost all of them include journalists that come along that you can pick their brains about what's the best angle for my story or what's the best way for me to get it out there. And they work with you to come up with the angle, and then they edit your media release. So you still learn how to write, because I think that's really important. Even people that can't write, and I can't tell you how many people come to my courses saying they can't write. It's only 400 or 500 words really for a media release.
Yep.
So we just help you get that hook and help you understand what the media is looking for. So that's kind of what Handle Your Own PR is. And I've helped people do over 650 campaigns now. So it's pretty exciting. And at the PR Accelerators, which is my sort of main focus, we have a 90% success rate. So everyone is getting published, and 50% of them are getting on TV. So
wow, yeah,
pretty exciting.
Yeah, that's really exciting. So I guess, Jules, when you talk PR, what is PR? What does PR look like, you know, as far as getting your message out there, and why? Why PR as opposed to every other piece of marketing that we could do, all the other marketing channels? Why is this an important one that, you know, I guess a lot of small business owners don't really
think about?
I think
that is a really, really good question, because a lot of people confuse PR with social media as well. Yep. But the kind of PR I'm talking about, so PR stands for public relations, but the kind of PR I'm talking about is getting yourself featured in the mainstream media. So it's talking about getting yourself in magazines and newspapers, on radio and on TV and in blogs. So it's not about getting yourself an Instagram influencer. And the reason that I think a lot of people don't think about it is they think, firstly, that it's going to be really hard to do.
Yeah.
And I also think that people are intimidated by the idea of contacting the media. And we all have that kind of thing where we go, little old me, like you wouldn't want to talk to little old me. But the reality is that journalists are desperate for people to send them stories. We have a whole lot of journalists that come to our events, and one said that the journalists these days have to come up with 7 articles a day. So
wow.
You can't do that by yourself. You have to have people give you ideas.
Yeah, that's incredible. And I guess that was probably one of the biggest things that you taught me about PR was, you know, that they want to hear from me as much as I want to, you know, get in contact with them, which you kind of almost think of these people as almost little superstars. You know, that superstar, you know, they wouldn't want to hear from me. They write for X, Y, and Z, or they're on TV. So that was a really big learning curve that you'd actually given me myself. So, yeah.
Oh, great. Thank you. And in terms of why PR is so good, it's because, firstly, it's free, so there is no money that exchanges hands. If you can come up with a good story, a magazine or a newspaper will run it, and you don't have to pay them to do it. So that makes it very attractive if you've got a small budget. The other thing is that the other two things really are that you get that third-party endorsement. So instead of like with an ad where you have to basically say, aren't I great, or isn't my business great, come and use me, this is somebody else saying, look at this great business we found, or here are some great tips from an expert that we found. And on the back of that, you get that third party endorsement, and people straight away go, wow, I must go and check this out. There's none of that kind of are they shonky feeling, because people feel that the media have checked you out first and that you must be a leader in your field. And the other thing, to go back to leader in your field, is that it positions you as being an expert.
Yes.
So, you know, if you manage to write an article, for instance, if you wrote an article about, you know, 5 things that small business owners are doing wrong when they use their social media channels, and you send that to a small business media outlet, they would love it and they will run it for you. And that gives you credibility straight away.
Yeah.
So it's a beautiful thing, really. And there's a lot you can do with it afterwards.
Yeah, absolutely. Repurposing marketing. Now that's, you know, very sweet, very sweet piece of advice there. So I guess, Jules, is PR, you know, is that for every business? Is there any businesses that you've come across that PR just won't work for? Or conversely, is there any businesses that it works exceptionally well for?
Look, the media really want to talk to business owners. So whether you pay an agency or you do it yourself, in the end, you are the person that they want to speak to because you're the expert in your particular area. The kinds of businesses that I myself find it difficult to help people is if they're in a franchise, because what tends to happen in a franchise is that you would, the way that PR works is that you send people to a website for more information. Mm-hmm. And if you're a franchise, you normally are going to send it to Captain Snooze or, you know, whatever the name of your franchise is. So therefore you're benefiting everyone in the group and not just yourself.
Right.
So that can be a difficult one. And the other one is party plan. So yep. Even though you might have your own website for Jeunesse or for Thermomix or whatever, you are still building the brand, and it's very hard to get those customers to go to your website and not just Google Thermomix and go and find whoever their local person is. So they're probably the two that are hardest, but there is always a way to spin a story, always.
So I guess on that, for people who might be listening today who haven't got to the stage yet where they have a website, they might have their social media channels, but they don't actually have a website, or they perhaps they have one that they're not happy to be sending yes. people to because it needs updating and that sort of thing. What sort of advice can you give those people who might be listening?
I would tell them to have a website, to be honest. There is no other answer. I would have to say that these days, if you're in business, the first thing that people will do is Google you. And so you have to have some kind of a web presence. So the media won't send people to a Facebook page or a LinkedIn profile. They will always want to send someone either to a bricks and mortar store or to a website. But also the journalist is going to Google you, and they want to see what it is that you do and all your potential customers do. So my hint there would be, it's $500 probably to put together a pretty simple website, put together the website before really you do very much marketing at all. I mean, really, websites are crucial these days. I think you've got to have a professional presence out there.
Yeah, I do totally agree with you. But unfortunately, you know, some people, it's just not in their budget and that sort of thing. But if they want to get their name out there, if they want to, because obviously PR has the advantage of really growing your business name and, you know, your profile and your expertise really quite quickly. You know, and you are totally right that, you know, if you're missing that element of a website, then perhaps, you know, that's not making you look like the expert that people perceive you are.
Look, I've worked with some people that maybe just have a splash page, which is really just a single page under your domain. And ideally on there, you would say, you know, website coming soon, or we're fixing it up. If you're interested, you know, leave your email address. And that's one way of capturing people so you can market to them later.
Yeah.
But you've got to have some kind of a web presence, I think.
Yep. Okay. So cool. Jules, what makes a good PR piece? Like before you gave a really great, headline about social media and that sort of thing. So what are the elements that you're looking for? Because obviously it's not written about, you know, if we take social media and Marketing Australia, my business, it's not about me. It's about, you know, giving my expertise for free in the PR. So what are the elements that make a really good PR article that will be picked up quite quickly?
Well, you actually said it perfectly then. So it's not about you. I think the biggest trick with PR is to realize it's not about you. It's about their readers. So if you can give them something that adds to their knowledge, that adds to their day, that makes them laugh, that makes them cry, any of those sorts of things, then they're in. One of the things that we've just heard recently is how badly the digital media are looking for videos, which I didn't realize. So there's a little tip for you.
Wow.
But if you can send them a couple of minutes of video that is information that is useful to their readers, they will apparently gobble that up. So I'm about to start promoting that myself and see whether it works.
Well, you found it here first, guys. On the
that's
small
right, you found it here first.
Podcast.
So the other thing that's really crucial to photography, particularly if you've got a product, is your photography. You won't get PR without the store, without a good photo. But the flip side is that I was speaking with the editor of a very influential magazine the other day, and she said, if I get a good photo, I'll find the flipping story. Like, I'll work with you to get the story because the photo is so important to them. So that's the second thing. And then other than that, just remember that if you're writing, you are not writing a letter to a journalist to ask them to write a story for you. You are really writing as if you are the journalist, and you're offering information to people. So everybody is an expert at something. Everybody knows something that other people don't know. And I think one of the things that I say to people is if you go out to a barbecue or a party, and you tell people what you do, there will be those same three questions that that keep cropping up that people always ask you. Take those questions, turn the question into a headline and explain or answer it underneath. And that's a really good way to get started. So offering tips and advice is the easiest way to get coverage, and your chances of getting picked up become 9 out of 10. You know, it's really, really probable that you will get picked up if you can offer some great tips for people or something they don't know.
Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Now, heading back a little bit, you did actually talk about a PR article. I think you said it was around 500 or 600 words or something like that. Is that kind of the norm of what you're looking or what they're looking for?
Yes. Yes. So what you want to do is whether you're trying to get the journalist to write the story, which is what would happen in a newspaper, or if you are doing your own kind of tips for people, you want about 400 or 500 words. It needs to be very punchy. Your first 2 or 3 sentences need to say what the whole media release is about. So there is no point getting waffly at the beginning and then getting into the details. Spin it all around, excuse me, and put the detail up at the top. But you want 500 or 600 words. You want to get very quickly to the point, and then you can expand on it underneath. And you need to make sure that all your details for how people can get to you via a website are down at the bottom. And that's pretty much it.
Yep. Okay. Beautiful. So I talk a lot to my audience about, you know, whatever marketing they do to look at what the return on the investment is. So I guess to do an article or to get on TV or to get in a newspaper or an online blog type of thing, what's the return on the investment? What do you generally see with your students and people that you have contact with if they get that exposure? What sort of return on their investment do they? I know the investment's free.
Other than time. So there is a time investment and normally a small amount of it, you know, like you might need to do something like sign up to our website for the contacts.
Yes.
But I mean, you could also research them if you literally have no money. So the return on investment is huge. I've just been tracking all my students recently. So the sorts of things that can happen are we had one person who got an article in Mamma Mia. She got 1,000 extra likes on Instagram within an hour of the article going out.
Wow.
We have a girl that was working with me today, has had a whole lot of articles. Last year, she had a 23% increase on her social media following, purely from the PR. She's also had, each time she does an article, she gets at least 2 inquiries from new customers who will contact her saying, I read this article about you. You know, where I get people at my accelerators from articles that I've written or articles that have been written about me. Okay. You can often get speaking requests. So one of the girls who's had quite a few articles published now said that somebody had looked up Australian expert on branding, and because she'd written so many articles, they contacted her and asked her if she would go to America to do a talk for them.
Wow.
That sort of thing can happen for you. Mm-hmm. If you start writing regular articles, the media will start to know what it is that you do. So they will come back to you for comments because you are the expert in your field. And I had one other woman who was a business coach, and she did one article. I'm not actually sure where she got it in, but she said she got 16 new business inquiries that month. And that is the only thing that she did differently.
Wow.
So what it does is your customers will find you. They will go looking for you if they like the sound of what it is that you're writing.
Yeah, great. And I guess
very powerful.
Yes. Well, it definitely sounds like it can be, most certainly. And I guess, you know, for anyone who's listening, who I often talk about, you know, it's not about the numbers. It's not how many likes you get and things like that on social media. But I guess the difference with what we're talking about today is they're qualified likes. They have literally engaged with you and now they are starting to follow you. So it's not like running a competition where it could be Joe Blow who's decided to, you know, win the vase or something like that. No. Qualified leads, possibly. So it is a little bit different. So if anyone's out there going, oh, but Jen, you always say it's not about the likes and Jules has just spoken about them. It is slightly different because they are highly qualified because they've already had some sort of touch point with you.
Yes, and I couldn't agree with you more. Having 1,000 likes from people in India is the next best thing to useless. Like, they need to be your customers. By the way, let me just go back to how do you write a media release. Two other things I forgot to say. Yep. If you're writing blogs or you're writing articles for LinkedIn, then you're already writing what could be a media release. And if you actually sent that off to the media before you publish it yourself, it may get picked up, which means that you'd be able to use that article in your blog or in your social media, but with the extra cachet that it's been published by someone.
So, and I guess on that point, Jules, is that an important point that it has to be original content, that it can't be necessarily something you've repurposed or that you are intending to repurpose? It has to be original?
You could repurpose it, but you'd need to rewrite the heading and change some of the words, because the reasoning behind that is that Google only will value something once. So therefore, if it sees the same thing four times, yes, it only values it once. So each media outlet wants that Google ranking. So therefore, they don't want something that's been published somewhere else. Having said that, in my Handle Your Own PR Facebook page, I've had three people in the last 2 weeks talk about getting the same article picked up six times.
Yeah.
So even though it's not great for the media outlet, if they don't know and they do it, it's fantastic for you, because then you get six backlinks into your website from other people publishing those articles. And unless they ask for an exclusive, there's no reason why you wouldn't just send them something that's already been published.
Good point. Jules, just before we wrap up, this has been really invaluable. So I hope this has kind of sparked something in my audience, perhaps someone who hasn't thought about using PR, or perhaps someone who thought that, you know, PR was, for bigger places. But is there any sort of tips or tricks that we haven't managed to cover so far that, you know, is really important?
Well, I guess for me, I would just say, regardless of your size, so I teach people to do PR that have Kickstarter campaigns for a startup and it doesn't even exist yet. And that works really well if it's a really interesting one, right the way through to big business. But I think everyone should be doing PR. And the other thing is that if you are spending a small amount of money advertising in a local paper, what PR will allow you to do is go to, you know, the Sydney Morning Herald rather than the Innisfail Weekly or whatever. So you can think really big, think Fin Review, think Women's Weekly. One of my girls managed to get a 12-page, well, she has a business called the Cool to Be Kind Project, and she pitched it to Women's Weekly, and they did the 12 Days of Kindness before Christmas featuring her business because she pitched it. So if you are in regional areas, Women's Weekly, and you're targeting women, Women's Weekly is another terrific magazine to go to, and they look for those kind of stories.
Wow.
I would just say think big and think of a magazine that you dream to be in or a newspaper you dream to be in, and then approach them.
All right. That sounds great. Great. Absolutely. Dream big. I think, you know, my tagline to this podcast is there's no point in dreaming small. So you've hit that one on the head. That's great.
Oh, fantastic.
All right, Jules, thank you so much for this interview. It's been fantastic. I hope everyone has got something out of it and really encouraged to, try PR in their business. Of course, all the links will be in the show notes, guys. If you want to get in contact with Jules, just Jules. Well, I guess I should ask you, Jules, what's the best way for someone to get in contact with you?
The best way is probably to email me on jules@handleyourownpr.com.au, which you will be able to stick in the link.
Yep.
And the only other thing that I was going to say is we do have a trial on our platform, if anyone wants to give it a go, that it's just $1. So you can have 2 weeks to play, but you do need to cancel within that 2 weeks if you're not happy. Otherwise, we're going to subscribe you for a year. And I've also got a free webinar, so I'll give you the link for that, and maybe you can see if people want to know a bit more. I've got a little half-hour thing on why they should all be doing PR.
Yeah, beautiful. All right, perfect. Cool. All right, Jules, thanks again. I look forward to catching up with you in person again shortly. But, thank you so much for coming on and providing such awesome value to my audience today.
My absolute pleasure. Thanks so much for asking me, Jen.
So guys, what did you think of that? How awesome was that? I hope you got some real value from it and you've begun to realize or perhaps get a little bit more encouraged on how you can get some free PR into your business to help you not only attract more customers and more clients, but really set yourself up as the expert in your field. As Jules mentioned, she does have this trial of $1 for 14 days on her platform. And if you'd like to take up this offer, and I definitely think you should, if you've never done PR before, then this will give you some real insights in just how easy it can be. The link, of course, is in my show notes at socialmediaandmarketing.com.au, or simply go to socialmediaandmarketing.com.au/PR. So that's socialmediaandmarketing.com.au/PR, and you can get her offer there. But that's it for episode 14. I hope you've not only enjoyed this episode, and it's definitely been great to have Jules on. Thank you again so much, Jules. If you have any questions or queries about winning free PR or how that could look in your business, please head over to Like-Minded Business Owners in there, ask your questions, and I'm sure that Jules would be happy to help you with anything, and also, you know, tag myself in there as well so that I can help answer your questions as well. Of course, I will be back next week with more marketing know-how and another fantastic discovery. If you're really liking this podcast, I would seriously love you to leave a rating and review. They are like gold for podcasters like me, and I will, of course, be eternally grateful. And I am, of course, eternally grateful to have you in my world as well. If you have any queries, questions, or comments, feel free again to either drop me a DM in Instagram at Small Business Made Simple, or, of course, head into the Facebook group. But thank you. I know this has been a bit longer of an episode, but I hope that you have seen the value that I have been trying to give you in the episode, even though it was a little bit longer. So again, guys, I'll catch you next week. Happy winning free PR. And remember, my small business peeps, as my opening song says, there's no point in dreaming small. Oh, if you feel lonely, say it loud. There's no time like the present. Tell it like you feel it, say it proud. Be true and let us see you for the star that you are.